Let's talk about methylene blue dosage. This is something people have asked me about. I have looked at the human research. I'm going to show you the actual human research and the results of that research to help you make a more informed decision for you. I am unbiased. I'm not selling methylene blue. I don't work for any supplement company or pharmaceutical company. Rather, for over 30 years, I've been analyzing research and helping you understand supplements. And for more information, also see my other methylene blue videos that I have here for even more information. And again, just like this one, all of them are unbiased as well. So when people talk about methylene blue, I often hear them talking about a dosage that is around 1 to 2 milligrams per kilogram. From what I can tell, some of these people are getting that dosage from the StatPearls website. But when you go to the StatPearls website, they're actually using that 1 to 2 milligrams per kilogram dose for methemoglobin. And from what I can tell from the StatPearls website is that many of the recommendations for methylene blue involve giving people infusions of methylene blue. That's very different than taking it orally with an eyedropper. And for those who have been to the StatPearls website, I also want to call your attention to the section of that page where it states that there is no known antidote for methylene blue toxicity. What this means is you want to be careful if you're going to self-experiment with this stuff. Another thing to know is that methylene blue, when taken orally, has a half-life of about 20 hours. This means it takes about 20 hours for half of it to be removed from your body. In other words, it stays in the body for a long time. And when you do take this stuff orally, you are absorbing about 70% of it. So you're absorbing a good amount of it. Now let's look at some of the human research on methylene blue and how much was actually used and what the results were of those studies. Methylene blue has been investigated to see if it helps people with Alzheimer's disease. And here is one of those papers. 321 people with mild to moderate Alzheimer's symptoms were studied for about 6 months, 24 weeks, and they gave them three different amounts of methylene blue, 69 milligrams, 138 milligrams, and 225 milligrams a day. Results showed that the 138 milligram dose of methylene blue appeared to be the best. Those who had moderate Alzheimer's disease, they saw about a 5-point improvement on their Alzheimer's test scores. Neither the 69 milligram dose or the higher 225 milligram dose had any significant effect on Alzheimer's symptoms. In other words, more is not necessarily better. Here's another paper on Alzheimer's disease. This one is larger. 981 people with mild to moderate Alzheimer's symptoms are studied for 15 months. They gave them either 75 milligrams twice a day or 125 milligrams twice a day, or they gave them a lower dose as a control group of only 4 milligrams per day. This paper paints a totally different picture. Neither dosage of methylene blue had any significant benefits. However, in this paper, they actually used a different version. They used leucomethylene blue, which may not penetrate the brain as well. And see my brain video on methylene blue for more information on that version. Here's a clinical trial of people who have bipolar disorder. These people were treated with either 5 milligrams of methylene blue 3 times a day or 65 milligrams 3 times per day, and they gave it to them in capsules. It was reported that those who took the higher dose actually had better benefits than those who took the lower dose. But they were also taking other medications as well. In other words, nobody in this study was only taking methylene blue. In this paper, 60 people who had mouth pain following cancer therapy are given 3.5 ounces of methylene blue as an oral rinse, and they gave it to them in 3 different doses. Either a 0.025% solution or a 0.05 solution or a 0.1% solution. Results showed that all 3 strengths of methylene blue reduced oral pain significantly, and this pain reduction occurred quickly from almost immediately to up to 24 to 48 hours later. Even more interesting is this paper involving 80 people in the hospital, and they're suffering from that condition that they all made us get shots for a couple years ago. And they give them for 2 weeks methylene blue in conjunction with vitamin C and N-acetylcysteine. Results showed that those who took the cocktail of methylene blue, vitamin C, and acetylcysteine not only spent 4 days less in the hospital, but they lived longer than those who got the standard care of treatment. Here's a table of the studies I just covered, and I also threw in a couple other investigations that I didn't cover, so absolutely take a close look at these results and the dosages of methylene blue that were used. As you can see, the dosages that were used in clinical trials are all over the place. That said, when it comes to the methylene blue fluid, the blue fluid you're probably most familiar with that you use an eyedropper with, it comes in different strengths, anywhere from 0.5%, 1%, 2%. At this stage of the game, I don't see any reason to think that greater strengths of methylene blue will be better than a lower strength. In fact, in most of the studies I saw, the solution strength of methylene blue wasn't even mentioned. Based on that, I would be cautious and use the lowest strength of methylene blue that you can find. As for methylene blue supplements, when I searched, I saw products that ranged anywhere from 7 to 12 milligrams per capsule. And as I mentioned previously, don't assume that more is going to be better. When shopping for a brand, look for companies that are showing you their certificate of analysis. That's going to tell you how much methylene blue it has, whether it has formaldehyde, heavy metals, etc. Any company that does not show you a certificate of analysis, swipe left and move on. No matter which brand of methylene blue you decide to try, be cautious with dosages that are given out by influencers online, because I'm convinced that most of them don't know what they're talking about. By starting with less than a company or an influencer is telling you to take, you are giving your body time to get used to this product, and you are also minimizing the potential side effects that may arise as well. And don't make the mistake of thinking that more methylene blue is better, because that's not necessarily true. And lastly, I'd be remiss if I didn't tell you that 99% of the research on methylene blue is not on humans. We have a long way to go to better figure out what this stuff does in the body, so I suggest caution, and if it were me, I would wait for more human research.